Well, it is a sign of relief in the first instance that our cry has been heard in the quarter where it will have some effect, and that is at the legislature, at that decision-making body. And the announcement by the Honorable Prime Minister was welcome news, not only for myself, but all members of our community. I am sure other Trinidadians, as they have expressed over years, support for our call for this recognition in the form of a one-off public holiday. So it is indeed welcome news, and it brings us a step closer to the rightful recognition that we deserve here in this country.
What are some of the other steps that need to be taken in the rightful recognition?
Well, there is a number of things that we see leading up to the recognition. You know, October 14th was granted a few years ago as a day of recognition, not a holiday. But in that, people are lost, because even in Arima, when we celebrate, people do not know what is happening because they have to work. Students have to attend school. They have their other business activities and so on. So in spite of all the efforts, you are lost. So we feel with this, where the country will stop for one day, no one after that should stop and say they don't know about the existence of the First Peoples, whether the past, history, the present, and the plans for the future. They would have to know, both students and adults alike. Things we would like to see is from that moment, like calendars to be printed both by the government printery and other corporate bodies printing calendars, should have on them October 14th as the day of recognition of First Peoples, so that every year people will be reminded and they will know that this day is set aside to, you know, focus on our First Peoples. That is one, and there are other details which I cannot go into all the details now. I expect that sometime shortly we may receive some official correspondence from the Honorable Prime Minister in regards to his pronouncement. And then when that is done, I think a discussion will take place, and then we can, you know, chart the way forward to whenever the day will really be celebrated.
I didn't start off our conversation by greeting you by saying Mabrika, but at the same time, but language is an important signifier in any community.
In any community, that's right, yes.
I'm also wondering, how important do you see it to be able to tell your story? Because there have been so many myths, so many fallacies that have happened.
Well, exactly. And you see, leading up to the day, whenever the day, as I said, is determined, leading up to that will be a process. We expect to go out into the communities. We expect to go out into the schools to do lectures to sensitize the people. We have, on a very limited basis, language classes that we do from time to time. We will intensify that so that people at least can know what are the greetings, good morning, good afternoon, how are you, and things like that in the language. So it's a lot of work to be done, and I think with the recognition of the one-off holiday, the national community will be sensitized, and the support that is needed, because it's more than just a holiday, the support that is needed in these different areas to build capacity as it pertains to language, spirituality, craft, culinary skills, you know, music and so on, I think people will be more up to supporting the different programs that we will put forward.
And Chief, I wanted to speak about spirituality a little bit, in the sense that it seems as though there is a move towards means or methods of spirituality that acknowledge the fact that we need to live more in harmony with nature moving forward. We need to be sustainable the way that we... The footprint that we leave, what we leave behind us, should not be detrimental to the generations that are coming behind us. What is your take on that?
Well, certainly I agree with that, because, you know, the spirituality of the First Peoples impacts upon every aspect of their daily lives. For instance, if somebody is doing pottery, if they are making a craft on pottery, pots and different things out of clay, they first have to ask permission and blessings to harvest that clay. They just don't go and dig up and just take it out. They are very conscious of the nature. Similarly, the forest, if they have to extract anything from the forest, they have to ask permission, you know, of the spirits or the guardians of the forest. And they do not just cut and take parts, but they seek ways of utilizing every aspect of that tree or that plant or whatever they have harvested. So it is not just a destruction for a certain part of it, but they utilize every part of you know, whatever they are harvesting. And that is just one aspect. That's just touching the tip of the iceberg. The spirituality, as I say, impacts on every aspect of the daily lives of the First Peoples. And, you know, in the past, our forefathers had that so packed. It was so real to them that they did wonders. Today we have lost some of that. And I think with all that is happening, we need to rebuild it and to reclaim it, so that it will, you know, prove to be a blessing not only to ourselves, but to the future generations, as you mentioned before.
In terms of having your own story, in terms of telling what is the truthful, the last time we spoke, there was a book that was just published. I'm wondering what is the progress, what is the status of that?
Yes, well, you know, the book was written by Professor Eri Bomert out of Holland, and it was launched here in Trinidad. We had a limited amount of the copies, and we are still awaiting, copies to arrive to us, a shipment of the copies. And that book is very well compacted. It speaks of the history, it tells of the past, it tells of the present, the survivors today, and, you know, our plans for the future. So it's a very comprehensive book that I think will give people a very good understanding of our First Peoples. Of course, it don't contain everything about First Peoples, but it will certainly give you a very good detail of the First Peoples. As soon as we get the shipment, of course, you know, we will let the people know, the general public know that where it is available so that they can access it.